Hello, welcome to my third tutorial on the software engineering series. In this lesson, we'll be focusing on two chapters. The first part will focus on software design and implementation, in other words, software development. And then the other part will look at software testing. So now let's begin. As part of this lesson, we'll be looking at software design, types of system design or types of software design, software implementation, system testing, and then the types of system testing. So now let's look at software design. So what do we mean by software design? This is a process to transform requirements into some suitable forms, which helps the programmer in software coding. The output of this process can directly be used into implementation in programming languages. So in our previous lesson, we looked at software specification, that is gathering the various software requirements. So now, after the software requirement has been gathered, we develop them into various charts or various diagrams that will serve as a guide for the software developer. So after the software requirement has been gathered, the developer or the software engineer sit down and put them or place them into a form or a structure that is easily understood and easily convertible into a form that can be executed on the computer. So example of these diagrams include the CIDO code, which briefly explain the various processes, or which uses mnemonics to explain how each process should go. And then the flowchart, that is, it shows the flow of the software, how the software should actually work. Now let's move on to look at the various types of software design. So the first one we will talk of is the architectural design. So when we talk of architectural design, it involves the overall structure of the system, the principal components, which is sometimes called the modules, and their relationship. So the architectural diagram looks at the various components that comes or that should come within a software. So let's take a look at a school management system. So with a school management system, we can talk of the various components, such as classroom management, fees management, system user management, login management, faculty management, and then the student management. So these components are what we put together to get the school management system. So drawing out these components and then their relationship, how they relate to build the system we are looking out for, that is what we term as the architectural diagram or the architectural design. The second one we talk of is the component design. So this involves identifying how each component within the architectural diagram should operate. This may be a simple statement or design depicting how the components work. So with a component diagram, it picks each component within the architectural design. So from the example here, we can see the components or the various components as class management, fees management. So when we pick one and then describe its function, that is what comes under the component design. So taking, for example, class management. And then as we are saying over here, this may be a simple statement or design depicting how the components work. So classroom management, then we say it will keep track of various classrooms within the school. So that becomes the component design. So example, the fees management model will keep track of students' fees payment, generating fees receipts, and generating students' bill reports. So this statement is actually explaining how the fees model or the fees management as part of the school management system is going to work. The next one is the interface design. So with the interface design, looks at the various interfaces that should come as part of the software. So thinking, for example, with the software, we will have a login screen. So how should the login screen be designed? How should the login screen look? What colors should we put together to form the login screen? So the interface design actually looks at the looks or focuses on the looks of the software. Then we move on to database design. So this is where you design the system's data structures and how they are to be represented in the database. So if the system actually involves a database, this is where you draw your various database schemas, your various tables, and then their relationship. So with these designs, it is not, or a software is not supposed to have all of these designs. Some softwares are made up of only the architectural design and the component, architectural design component, and then interface design. So it is not compulsory that every software should comprise all these four designs. So let's move on to look at software implementation. It says, this is the process of converting system specification into an executable system. It is mostly referred to as software coding. At this stage, computer codes are written using programming languages such as C#, Java, VB, and others. So with the software engineering, after we've gathered all our requirements, after we've done our various designs, this is where we convert the design into the actual software. So the implementation is also known as software coding. So that is where we write computer codes using computer languages, programming languages to actually develop the real world software the client is actually looking for. Now let's move on to look at software testing. So with software testing, it is also known as verification and validation. So when we talk of verification, this is where the programmer, after writing all the computer codes, take time to look through the codes to see if it is error free or it has no errors, and then it's actually meeting its goals. So the developer takes time to go through the entire system over and over to see it is free from errors. And then with the validation, that is where we give the system to the user to test to see if the system is actually working the way he wants it. So the verification is done by the developer, whereas the validation is done by the client. So with the software testing, it ensures that software conforms to its specification and that it meets the expectations of the system customer. So the software testing focuses on verifying and then validating if the software has actually met its goals. So we say it involves ensuring that the software has achieved its goals without any bugs or errors, as it has already been explained. So let's move on to look at the types of testing. So we have component testing. So when we talk of component testing, this is where we take each component of the software to test it to see if the system is actually free from bugs. So taking, for example, the example I cited with the school management system, we got to know of the fees management as a component of the school management system. So when we take the fees management system alone, and then we test it to see if it is error-free, we term it as component testing. So picking one component and then testing it to see if it is working as expected. So from the component testing, then we move on to system testing. So with the system testing, that is where we put all the various components together to form a whole. So with the architectural diagram I showed earlier, we saw a fees management system, we saw class management system. So when we put all of them together, or when we integrate all of them together, then we test to see if everything will function perfectly once they've been fitted together. Then the last one we'll talk of is acceptance testing. So with the acceptance testing, that is where we give the system that we've tested to the user to also test. So over here, we can give the system to the user and tell the user, okay, use the system for like 3 months to see if everything works as you want. So that is the acceptance testing. All right, so we are going to end here. In our next lesson, we'll be looking at software process methods. Please, if you've not subscribed to this channel, kindly hit on the subscribe button below. Thank you for joining this lesson. Bye-bye.